morning, welcome back to my channel. So this morning Chris and I got up nice and early and went and did cardio, so I've now got 35 minutes of cardio to do. So I did that on the stepper, got back, had a shower, had a quick bite to eat, like literally an apple, and I've done the food shop and have now got back to a skinny food parcel. So I thought I would go through what we've picked up. They had a massive sale on over Easter. So we got a couple of their spreads. So we got the peanut butter, the toffee spread. I don't know why that was so hard for me to say. We've got the tikka mayo. I've heard really good things about this. And then the chip shop curry sauce. We've had it before. Really, really nice. And then to make my pancakes more interesting, whilst I still have them in my diet, in my plan, we got a few syrups. So I got the banana and caramel syrup, the gooey egg, which is supposed to be like the inside of a cream, Cadbury's cream egg, and then the chocolate orange. This smells more orange than it does of chocolate orange, but I'm hoping it will be good. I have chocolate orange protein powder in my porridge, and I'm thinking about drizzling some of this on it as well and seeing how that goes. So yes, this is quite a watery consistent, whereas the others are quite thick. So that is everything we've got. Very exciting. So my plan today is just to crack on with some work. I've got 10k steps that I need to do. No training this evening. I'm gonna go and make, I've got a bagel thin and some Biscoff, but I might change the Biscoff out for the peanut butter. I'm not sure. Unsure. So I'm gonna go make that in a second and grab a cup of tea and then crack on and tidy up and then get on with stuff that I need to do, basically. So I've just made my, I guess, first meal. I've had an apple today, which you would have seen. I've made myself a cup of tea, bagel thin with 25 grams of Biscoff on it. So I'm gonna sit and eat that. I've also got a hot water bottle because I think I've trapped a nerve either in my rhomboid, my trap, or my lat. And it's just causing a lot of pain going up my neck. It's a lot better than it was yesterday, but applying heat on it and just trying to take it easy as well. So yeah, that's the plan. That's what I'm gonna do now, and I will catch up with you in a bit. That went down far too easy. Gonna sit, drink my cup of tea, and then crack on. So it is now lunchtime, and I've got 60 grams of oats, 90 grams of berries, dark chocolate, and chocolate orange protein. I'm currently watching Kay Taylor's Journey to Worlds. I've been really loving watching Kay's prep vlogs. They've been so good. So yeah, I'm going to eat this, then I'm going to head out on a walk because it is sunny outside and I need to get steps. So I'm just getting some steps. I'm on 3,000. I need 11k today. So yeah, having a wander down to Asda, getting some steps. It's pretty warm, but there's really black clouds. So I think it's gonna chuck it down. So that's why I'm absolutely baking in my coat, but needs must. So yeah, heading down to Asda, have a wander around, get a couple of bits that I need, and then walk back again, and that should tick off quite a nice amount of steps. So I've just got back from my walk. I am now on 9,704 steps. So I've got like 1,300. I don't know why that was so hard for me to do math. 1,300 steps to get. I've just made my shake. So this has got 45 grams of Perform chocolate orange whey, 90 grams banana, and then I mix it with water. I used to religiously say that I would never mix porridge or protein shakes with water. It had to be milk or oat milk. I've grown up, I've got over myself, and I now have my porridge with water and my shakes with water. So I'm just gonna have this to tide me over between now and dinner. I got a couple of bits at Asda, thought I would show you. One of them is prep related, the others, I mean, no, a couple of them are prep related. Get it out on the bed. Just gonna move one of my squish fam out the way. Go over there, squishy. So the first things I got were these two. It was a classic, saw it when I was in the queue to pay. They were £2. They're sugar-free Mentos chewing gum. And they have like a gooey center. So spearmint flavor and then a tropical flavor. Just good to curb any hunger. So I picked those up and I thought I'll just chuck them in my bag for work. Because I'm trying to push food back, it'll just work out better. Next thing I got is Sominex herbal tablets, just to help with sleep. All herbal, so I'm gonna give those a go, just because sometimes I wake up really, really hungry and cannot sleep. So if I can just get a good healthy sleep routine or night routine now, then it's gonna benefit me long run. I also picked up some ultra magnesium. I've just heard a lot of people say to take magnesium, it's really good for you. And I was having a look and it says, you actually can't read that. It says, ultra magnesium may be suitable for those with hectic lives seeking extra bone support and over 50. Well, I'm not over 50. Extra bone support would be fab. And prep definitely means I have a hectic life with prep, training, work, uni. So yeah. That's going to be good. And it says to take it with your main meal, so I think I'm going to take it with my, oh my god, why can't I hold it? I think I'm going to take it with my evening meal. I then picked up some Batiste tropical dry shampoo because I'm doing so much cardio but I don't want to wash my hair all the time, because I'm trying to train it not to need a wash. Obviously it's kind of gross when you're sweaty, but do you know what, it's just prep life, gym girls will understand. So yeah, got it in this tropical. Why did I just take the flipping lid off? What's wrong with me? I got it in the tropical scent, heard really nice things about it, and Batiste is my favourite. I've tried a few different brands, but I always come back to this one, so that's that. And the final two things just aren't gym related at all, but I just got a new foundation, thought I would try the Maybelline Dream Radiant Liquid. And then I got this lip gloss because it drew me in, because it said it was plumping, it says hyaluronic acid. Oh, on the thing it said it was like a plumping lip gloss and a hydrating lip gloss, and I was like, oh, I like that. And then I really liked the colour, and then I looked at the name of it and the name was Moon. So I just thought it was a sign from the universe, you know, so it fell into my basket, and I'm gonna thoroughly enjoy wearing this to work, you know, because go to the gym and I don't know if anyone else has this issue, I go to the gym all the time obviously and don't wear makeup to the gym. Doing cardio, don't wear makeup obviously. If I'm working from home, I won't wear makeup. And then I just don't feel very girly, but I love getting dressed up, and I'm actually really, really a really big girly girl. So it's nice to sometimes just have little things like this that can just make you feel a bit better. So I'm in the office for work tomorrow, and I'm sure as heck gonna enjoy wearing this Moon lipstick that the universe sent me. So yeah. Anyway, I will catch you when we're making dinner, which won't be too long, so I need to drink my shake now. And I also need to upload my assignment for uni, so I'm gonna go do that. So, so Chris and I have just had our call with our celebrant. Basically, if you don't know, Chris and I are getting married next year, and we want to go down the kind of traditional route of having a registrar. We wanted to write our own vows, and we want our ceremony and our wedding to be really personal. So the best option for us is to go with a celebrant. But there's so much stuff behind it that we had no idea about. So we just basically needed to talk to someone, and I found a celebrant
that I really like the sound of. Chris was quite chilled, he's quite chilled about it all and was quite happy. So we've had a call and we both really love her. I mean, for starters, she's traveled to India many, many times, which, you know, India is coming into this wedding because it is the place that I feel at home. And it's the place I'm most excited to show Chris one day. She got everything that we were saying and everything we'd kind of spoken about. Granted, the ceremony is probably the most important part for me. Chris is just quite chilled about it. It's important to him. For the wedding, there's different aspects of it that mean more to us as individuals. The whole thing means everything to us as a couple, but there are definitely aspects where, like, you know, Chris has taken more ownership and more control of, and then same with me, which is really exciting. And yeah, for me, the ceremony was and is the most special part. And so having the right person marry us is so important. Really, really happy with how that went. So excited, we've got our date booked in, and I'm just so excited that it's all coming together. I'm also feeling quite overwhelmed and quite anxious because it's so fucking expensive. Obviously, like, of course it is, it's a wedding, and I think they're only gonna get more expensive as the years go on. But it's just about kind of saving, knuckling down, and yeah, moving forward with it, really. That's what we've just had. We had dinner, but I completely forgot to film it. I was so hungry, but I basically had like a chicken kind of wrap thing with a ton of veggies and tried the tikka mayo skinny sauce, which was incredible. I'm now off to my mum and dad's house, one, to explain to them about the meeting we've just had, and two, because I need my dad's help with something. So I'm heading there now. And then when I get back, hopefully it won't be too late. Final meal, which, shock, is my pancakes. Yes, he does. Hello.
So that's good.
That actually doesn't look bad in this at all.
So I'm just holding an ice pack to my head for no fucking reason, then.
Wow.
Great. What are we training tomorrow?
Pankogas.
We're training pankogas?
No, we're training legs, aren't we?
Are we?
Yeah.
Cool. How are yours feeling?
They're fine. My legs are feeling good. They're feeling funky fresh. Wait, not if you do that. Anyway, that is the end. We're gonna watch an episode.
You do realise it's
10. Yeah, but I got pancakes to eat.
It's 10 to 10, Mars.
Yeah, but I got pancakes. Do you wanna watch half an episode?
Yeah, that's fine.
Half an episode.